स्वामी जय जगदीश हरे। भक्त जनों के संकट, दास जनों के संकट क्षण में दूर करे। ओम जय जगदीश हरे। क्षण में दूर करे। ओम जय जगदीश हरे। तुम हो एक अगोचर सबके प्राणपति, विध मिलूं दया मैं, किस विध मिलूं दया मैं तुमको मैं कुमती। ओम जय जगदीश हरे।
ओम जय जगदीश हरे।
स्वामी जय जनों के संकट क्षण में दूर करे। ओम जय जगदीश हरे। मात पिता तुम मेरे शरण गहूं किसकी,
प्रभु शरण बहु में किसकी।
तुम बिन और न दूजा, प्रभु बिन और न दूजा आस करूं मैं जिसकी। ओम जय जगदीश हरे। ओम जय जगदीश हरे। स्वामी जय जगदीश हरे। भक्त जनों के संकट, दास जनों के संकट क्षण में दूर करे। ओम जय जगदीश हरे।
विनाशक जन सुखदायक, विघ्न विनाशक जन सुखदायक मंगलम गणेशा।
देवहु देवा गणपति देवा मंगलम गणेशम। देवहु देवा गणपति देवा मंगलम गणेशम।
विघ्न विनाशक जन सुखदायक, विघ्न विनाशक जन सुखदायक मंगलम गणेश।
देवा हो देवा गणपति देवा मंगलम गणेशम। देवाहु देवा गणपति देवा मंगलम गणेशम
मम गम 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 गस दद मद 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 मग निनि धनि 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 मग मदनि सग मदनि सग मदनि सग
महिमा तेरी अनंत
तू ही आदि तू ही है अंत
देव महिमा तेरी अनंत
गजाननम बुद्ध गणादि सेवितम उमा सुतम शोक विनाश कारकम मंगलम गणेश
देवा हो देवा गणपति देवा
मंगलम गणेशम
देवा हो देवा गणपति देवा
मंगलम गणेशम
विनाशक जन सुखदायक विघ्न विनाशक जन सुखदायक मंगलम गणेश देवा हो देवा गणपति देवा
मंगलाचरम तत्परम दर्शितम ओम श्री पाद्य स्नानम समर्पयामि।
Have you seated this time? As we settle ourselves in the way, we kindle that divine Shakti and energy within us. Tonight, if we tell you of the dedication and the hard work of this family, and especially the son, Avinash, if I tell you of a bhakta, of a child, a very true sadhak who has toiled and worked from since last year in the planning and the preparation, these wonderful two nights of yajna, of puja, of divine offering and blessings to the Bhagavan. And with so much love and praying that tonight, this evening, you get caught up in a magan of it. So before we start, because of that magan, that energy that you have created, allow Sivaji to sing. Magan Bhai to listen. Riva Bhali is Navani Avatundi Ki. I kindly ask you this time, children, to stand. Jury of this day. We have tonight Pandit Randi, we're here with us. Namaskar, Pandit Ji. And you, the wonderful members of this family, neighbors and friends. But our hand is jury, we chant.
Om Bhagavata Namahakaya Surya Koti Samprava Jagaram Guru Meva Sarva Karyeshu Sarvada
Om Vinadari Vipula Mangala Dana Shri
Vaktadi Nashini Viran Shri Harishavande Kirti Pradeva Kilamaru Vatera Mahari Kirya Pranayini Saraswati Rami
के मगन Thank you.
Let there be peace around us. But where does that peace begin? That peace must begin within us first. If you want happiness, then you have to give happiness. If you want to be loved, then you have to give love. If you want compassionate, then you yourself must become compassionate to others. There's a deal. The manifestation of Jagat Ambima, Divine Mother of this universe, Ari Shakti Chaitanya Meya. Jayanti, bolo.
Mangalakari, Bhadrakari, Kapalini, Durga Shama, Shivadatri, Swaha Swadha Namostute.
Thank you.
English. I don't think he's seen it. But I want to tell you something, children. Before, very first time before I came to Puja here or for Avinash, and first thing I asked, is there a guru for this family? And he said, yes, there's Pandit Harish. And Pandit Harish give his blessings to this child to have me as a young Pandita, and I'm sure to Pandit Randi here, and to those who would come to this home where mandirs, yagnas, this child would attend. So tonight we pay homage to such a guru who holds such a high status, not only society, but in the spiritual aspect and status in this country. And having these blessings is having the very blessings of my own Guruji, Pandit Dr. Brahman Ramachan. So I ask you to kindly use your hands together.
Om Sadguru Tvam Namami.
Om Sadguru Tvam Namami.
Om Sadguru Tvam Namami.
Om Sadguru Tvam Namami.
Akanda Mandala Karam
Vyapta Mena Chadacharam Tat Param Darshitam Yena Tasme Shri Guru Vena.
When he wrote this Ramayana Vivasha Avari Hindi, this is beautiful katha. It takes place from Uttar Khand. A katha is a conversation between Shiv Shankar Bhagwan and Parvati Ma, Durga Devi Ma, Uma, Girija. One day, Bhagwan Shri Ram, you know, he's wandering in the forest and he's looking for his wife Sita. So Shiv Shankar and Mara, Parvati, they are strolling. And do you remember the katha was also revealed to Mara Parvati by Shiv Shankar. And Shiv Shankar offer pranam and bow and salutations to Prabhu Shri Ram. And Parvati in that form, children, she says to him, "Hey Shankar, you are the lord of the three worlds. And yet you bow before this Ram." And Shankar did not answer. You see, no one can force you, children. Bhagwan does not teach just like that, right? From a book. He teaches by example. Shiv Shankar did not answer at all. So Parvati mom, she took the form of Siti. And she walked up to Bhagwan, Shyam. And in the moment he saw her, he said, O Devi, O Ma, where is Shiv Shankar? And she offered her pranam and she went back to Shankar. And she told him what happened. And Shankar, he smiled, but he said, since you have taken the form of my mother, you will no longer walk on my left side. You will walk on the right. And in you, after you, we know of the katha of the Lord. We know of the leela of the Lord. And this is what he is saying to her now. In this age, in this time, in Uttarakhand, he is saying now to Girija, to Uma, he's reminded her of that situation, and now he's saying this to her in this beautiful duo he tells.
Because sometimes every moment of our life,
The biggest battle we have is inside of here. It's inside of here. The kusam takes place inside of us all the time. That we will never be able to receive the prasad from the satsang. And that is why when you're in satsang, you'll hear to clap and to sing and to chant, as we shall do now. This beautiful job by Dells.
Mantra again, temple again this morning. We have the worst excuse.
So Jayashri is sitting now eagerly now. She wants to hear more. And he continues. Shivji kahne lagi, he Parvati, maine Shri Ramchandra ji ki katha varan ki, jo kali yug ke paap shant karni. You see, in this age of Kali, it is this age of Kali that we blame for everything. In this age of Kali, where all our sins are exposed now. All our sins. And who expose our sins? We ourselves. Nobody go and expose us, you know. We expose ourselves. You know how many times I hear people say, you see that one, I'm going to give them a piece of my mind. And then we would curse people. We would ill-treat people. With our own self. We would commit sins with our hands. And our mouth, by our own selves. We expose ourselves. So you see, in this age of Kali, when we ourselves expose our own sin, he says, what help? This katha. Listen to the leelas of Bhagavan. It is a life-giving remedy that can help us. That's why they say in this age of Kali, when we complain that it is so hard, the Bhagavan says, you see, in this age of Kali, it is easy for us to attain moksha and liberation because we do not have to what? To go and perform great tapasya and penance and all of that. All we have to do is what? Chant. Namo namo Durge Maharani. Namo namo Durge Maharani. Namo namo Durge Maharani. Get yourself involved in satsang. When you take your katha and you keep it to your heart, he says, you yourself have become as holy as the most holiest place. And he says, blessed is the land where the Ganga flows. Blessed is that woman who is faithful to her husband. Blessed is that child who is obedient to the Guru. And we have seen this. We have seen this over and over again in this home. For those of you who would know this family. I've heard so much about Pandit Harish that my heart is filled with so much love for him. I've heard so much of Pandita Mai that my heart is overflowing with love. I've heard so much about this young child, Pandit Rani, that my heart swells. And who I've heard it from? I call him my son, Avinash. He sings the praises of all gurus and all pandits that he meets. He loves them. He shows compassion to his friends and his family and his cousin. And you know, the very first day we met, on the very first day he came to the Daubich in the Mandir and he brought his little Ganesh with him, a bond was formed. That I had to tell him on the last occasion I did puja here, I have one son. And I said to him, child, if anything should happen to me, and I'm seeing this publicly here tonight, I told his parents, I took their son from them, that he'll be one of the young men who will perform. And then Jeremy said, so what happened to me? And I said, Jai Bhagwan, Jeremy, you too. And then the other children in the group said, and what about us? Children. I have learned from Avinash how to love equally. And everybody in our life gives us a reason to learn a lesson. He says, blessed is a Brahmin who serves not from his spiritual karma, who serves not, who sways away, who moves away, who veers away from his dharma. Blessed is that Brahmin who faithfully follows the rules and regulations, his dharmic rules and regulations. Blessed is that. He also says, blessed is a house that is spent in devotion, and blessed is a house where satsang takes place. Blessed is his home. Blessed is the air at here. And he continues and he's saying to her, O Devi, I am telling you all of this now, not that your heart is filled. Not that your heart is filled with so much of love. O Prabhu Shri Ram, O Girija, O Parvati, O Uma, O Durga Devi, I am telling you this now. And then he sees to her. As he looks at her so beautifully. And she's smiling. If any of you allow yourself to follow the Katha, you see how she sits so beautifully. As she listens. And she looks at her Swami. She looks at Shiv Shankar. Tumhi mere mandir. Bolo.
Tumhi mere pooja. Tumhi devata.
She
Let my mind always remember you, O Lord. Let my mind always think of you, people. Manabora Mata Javaji Rana Rani Kirtan. That my mind must never leave the feet of God. Whether you're driving, when you're cooking, when you're cleaning, whatever you're doing. Nara Yirna Hari Om. Chant, children, is the more you lift yourself. That's why Shivshank, remember the beginning I told you? He did not answer. Parvati Devi, he did not answer. No one can force us to fall in love with God. No one can go and bring a bag of love and say, look, okay, purchase this love, this is yours. I have purchased happiness, divine happiness, this is yours. I have purchased liberation. This is yours. Each and every one of us have to lift ourselves by our own self, for our own self. When you lift yourself, it doesn't do anything to me or to anyone else, but it is only for your benefit. But the minute you become uplifted and the minute you become a noble and divine soul, what happened? You yourself now can assist and lift. You can help them, but children, nobody cannot force you to taste the nectar of Bhagavan. No one can force us. This Leela has seven beautiful different steps of devotion. And of course, many of you will know the cutter of Shabdi Ma. I like to call her Sibri, or follow Siva if she perform, you know. And when we want to talk about an exalted harmony, when we want to talk about a woman, when we want to describe a devotion to Guru and to Bhagwan, we think of Shabri Ma. Nobody else but Shabri Ma, that Devi. From why? And for when? And for how? And who is she? From very tender age, living in the ashram of Matang Rishi, she was told by Matang Rishi and Guru that Bhagwan Shri Ram will come this way. He will pass this way. And what she did? She began preparation from early. Mere Ram aayenge, mere Bhagwan aayenge. She began to prepare. And the minute Avinash set date, he began to prepare. He began to prepare. When I saw the amount of work that was done here, I'm saying to Sunil, is this the same place? It's just the same place. You all did well. And she waited and waited every day. And what happened? When did Bhagwan come? He did not come same time. He came to her when she was a very old lady. But every day she prepared the same way. She made her malas. She cleaned the place. She picked her fruits. And she had everything ready. Ready for him. She did not give up. Like sometimes, you know, when we're doing things and it doesn't go our way, we are angry and we are upset. And oh, the Pandit didn't do a good job. And I have been fasting so long. And we're ready to give up. Somebody go to the Pandit says, okay, 9 Saturdays, 11 Saturdays, make offering. So, we begin to fast. After the 3rd Saturday, things is not working out still. Jai Bhagwan. You never tell us in Princess Tom have a nice Obeyman. So what do we do? We also go no by the Obeyman. Because why? We want a quick fix. There is no discipline in our practice. There is no discipline in our faith. We lose faith. And we lose faith because of ourselves again, not because of anybody else. He says, oh Girija, when one has faith and devotion in one's rites and rituals and a way of worship, faithfully and beautifully Hinduism, we see, and the feet of Bhagwan, then one definitely can cross the cycle of samsara. This beautiful Chopra tells. Really beautiful Chopra.
Jai Ram, 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 Jai Ram,
Oh, beautiful. That's really beautiful.
Shri Ram Jai Ram.
Says, oh Ma, oh Devi, जो मनुष्य यहाँ पर क्या करे इस गाथा को गाटे, that we have to learn to separate ourselves from our bad habits. And how we do that by singing and chanting and listening to the glories of Bhagwan. Children is like children, you know. It's like children, our mind is like that great ocean. And we can offer this poison, this halahala poison to Shiv Shankar. And what is the halahala poison? The halahala poison, children, is our hatred. It is our greed. It is our anger. That is the halahala poison. That is what we are contaminating ourselves with. And the more we allow ourselves to become part of the vices that grips us. Because many times in society, when you ask someone, you say, come to you for help, and you tell him, okay, you have to do this and you have to fast so long, and they want a shortcut method. We want to get the same result so fast. He says, the more you keep yourself in satsang, you are churning away this bad habit. When someone comes to gossip with you, don't spoil your ears. When someone comes to gossip with you, do not spoil your tongue and do not waste your time. If that gossip benefits you, Jai Bhagwan. But you must always ask yourself, what will this do for me? When we gather together to ill speak people, what does this do for me? And he's saying this to Uma. He says, Uma, in this age, if man gets rid, separate himself from his vices, from his ignorance, from his covetousness, then man can surely attain moksha, liberation. And this cycle of samsara becomes how? Te how, but if how, it becomes easy, as if you're crossing the puddle now. The cow foot, or not easy like that. This cycle of samsara. That's why we will be churn our mind by the mantra chant. Mantra jap, japahi tum heart. The more you chant the name of Bhagwan, the more the mind becomes purified. That's why in satsang, see how smart Goswami Tulsidas Ji is, Panditji, that every chaupai sloka, there is always Jai Ram Sita Rama. Keep us in line. This happens to keep us in line. And in some of us, what we do? When you say, sing chan chan. Arya Mali is Rama Ramachani ki. Hand will go up, nobody say Jai. That happened many times. We are blessed, we are fortunate that tonight we are surrounded by so much divinity and divine souls that you are chanting and you are singing. And then sometimes we ask ourselves, when you go to satsang, how come one person alone will chant and sing and you personate to them? Nothing. Nothing at all. Because why? You see, what we do sometimes, you see this divinity that we have? We sometimes put a veil of ignorance here. Sometimes we put a veil of hatred here. So that divinity is covered now. But the minute we rips it apart, the minute we chant and churn it away, we burst it away, then what happened? This divine light begin to shine. Just like Hanumanji. When Hanuman ripped his heart, each and everyone does not possess that same quality. To show love and to be divine, all of us have that. That's why I say in the beginning that each and every one of here, us here, we are all equal. I am not better than you. We are on the same playing field. Let your divinity shine. He says, Devi, he says, being in satsang will indeed take us out of the cycle of birth and death if we allow ourselves that. And it becomes easy for us. And many times people, you know, they will criticize you, especially when you see you're moving up spiritually. That's the time sometimes you have more problems. And Jai Bhagwan, somebody said, blame Mara Kunti Pai. Because she says, oh, Prabhu, you know, oh Krishna, it was only my problem that I can seek you and then give me more problem. That's why you see, you know, people who walk the spiritual life. And that is not a problem, children. Those are situations that are placed before us to see how we deal with it. To see how we can deal with such a situation. There's somebody God calling. Tell him God about this now, you're going to be here. How we deal with that situation. And that is why I say, do not look at caste or class, people lineage, where they have come from, who they are, their status, their family, their money, their strength, their wealth, their connections. Because Bhagwan Sri Ram clearly says, he clearly says this to Shabri Maa. Kaha Raghupati suno Bhamini Mata. Kaha Raghupati suno Bhamini Mata. Manahu ek bhag ti karnata. And if you were there with Shabri Maa and you witnessed in a katha, who you sit in with Girija, what you chant? Jai Ram Sita Rama. I am not concerned about your caste, your class, your connections, your wealth, your status, who you know and who you don't know. Bhagwan is not interested in that. The only thing that impresses the Lord is our faith, our love and our devotion. That is all. That's why when your children bring their thali to make offering, naivedyam offering, sometimes you see like Shivratri Nayak Panditji, 500 people lined up in the mandir and everybody looking at everybody talking to you, who are nice, who takes one, but Asaram and Kukunat came, you are not, we supposed to get that two flowers, what can you get tali? Jai Bhagwan, look at your own. And if your tali does not have love and faith and devotion, of what use is that offering? You can have all the sweetest mitai and the best of it all, but if that does not have love, pure divine love, not for God, not for Bhagwan, but for who? For the people around you. That those that surround themselves. Because how can you love God and you cannot love His creation? How can you say, I have so much respect and faith in Bhagwan, and then what we do with all that He's creating? We try to destroy that which He has created. And this doesn't mean to offend anyone. But sometimes we have young, beautiful pandits, they're growing up. We have nice young panditas, they're coming up in society. And what happened? Those above try to push them down. You see that in your workplace, children are studying and learning and they're growing. You see that in mandir and temple organization. They will not hand over to the younger children. We have become selfish. We have become greedy. And we cannot use Sanatana Dharma to practice greed. We cannot and we should not use it. We're supposed to sit here and embrace each other. We're supposed to sit here and love each other because our children are looking at us. And the more love you give, it is never empty. The more love. He says, oh Bhamini, oh Devi, when she is saying, Adama Deya, Adama, Adama, Atin Hari. That I am low, I am so low, there is nothing else lower in me. And if there is anything else lower in me, hey Prabhu, that I am. And she's crying and she's saying this. She has a rundown eyes and She cannot believe in this moment when she look at her hands and she look at her fingernails and she sees how her nails are all dirty and soiled and her clothes are scattered and torn. Who am I? Who am I to feed the Lord? Who am I to sit near to Him and to converse with Him? Who am I? I am nobody. I am dull-witted.
Ma, that does not concern me.
When the Lord met Shabri, she was already a liberated divine soul. Shabri did everything to attract the Bhagwan to her. What do we do? What are we doing to attract God to us? Right through the katha, different katha tell you that when Bhagwan went to Vibhishan, take Vibhishan for example. Vibhishan is a brother of Ravan. And in Lanka, it is where Hanumanji found him. And how he found him? By what mean? By what method? How he found him? He was chanting. What he was chanting? Ram Ram Bhaju, Ram Ram Bhaju. Ram Ram Siya Ram. Lord was attracted by his devotion. When Hanumanji also found Bharat, because he was chanting and worshipping the Gunka Rao of Prabhu Shri Ram, and he was chanting Raghupati Raghava. To attract the Bhagwan to us. Tell me, we prepare for everything in life. We prepare for so much of physical happiness. And we think physical happiness is what will drive us as a people and what will keep us. But physical happiness and material happiness, it is shortly, they are temporary. But happiness with Bhagwan is forever. And when you strive and you toil and you labor and you prepare, and again I'm going to remind you of Avinash. Because every day there's new preparation. When he built that mandir in front of his home, that was his joy. But you know what became his greatest joy? When he began to make the pathway to Mandir. Like Shabri, the pathway for the Bhagwan. And when our children do this, you must praise them. When you praise them, you encourage them. And when we encourage them, we motivate them. And when you motivate them, they are successful. And when they are successful now, they can also motivate others, help others, teach others. Hari Om Bol Durgadevi Maharani Ki Jai. This beautiful Devi Bhajan tells us, Sunaji will sing this wonderful, beautiful Bhajan for us.
Jagadambe, Jai Jagadambe Maha, Jai
yeah.
या देवी सर्वभूतेषु शक्ति रूपेण संस्थिता नमस्तस्यै 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 नमो चनिया पेंगल
कैसे तूने रूप बनाया मन लहराए तन लहराए
that is deep. She can take so many different forms. You know, sometimes when we think of the Devi, and we think of Lakshmi Ma, this beautiful Lakshmi before me, and we think of Saraswati Ma, we think of Lalita Devi, we think of Gauri Ma. What do you see? How does she present herself before you? As a child, when we think of the Devi, we think of the Shakti of the world, that a mother is comforting, that a mother is kind, that a mother is compassionate, that a mother will heal us and a mother will look after us.
Kali Kameli
महारानी की चुनाव। We about to almost come to the end of the ninth session. We about to come to closing. What the energy within us? We have recharged our spiritual batteries tonight. I'm going to ask you to continue to be in a receptive mood and mood. Begin your weekend. Begin your weekend in satsang. Tomorrow night, I know you're going to be here as you continue to support this beautiful family. They are like pillars of Sanatana Dharma, you know. And when children like this perform yajna, yajna means a sacrifice. But this is a Mahayagna because the amount of sacrifices that this family made, their young son Avinash, in order to have this place ready so that we can come and be comfortable. So we can come and sit, and they have provided a mandir here for us. They have allowed us to feel the energy of Bhagwan. They have given us a chance, an opportunity. When there are yajnas and satsang in a village, when there is a mandir in a village, that gives us an opportunity to chant and to sing and to mend our ways. It gives us an opportunity to serve God and to serve others. So Avinashji, to you and your family, on behalf of everybody here, we thank you tremendously for this wonderful opportunity. That way we can come and sing and chant, listen to Katha, to take the name of Bhagwan, to become part of the beautiful puja that was done by Pandit. Listening to the glories being sung also by the group. And when you clap and sing, you add to the divinity of the atmosphere. I would kindly ask you to stand as we join in closing aarti. In aarti, each and every one of you, please take your thali out in your mind. Remember, the Bhagwan, you have stopped the Bhagwan in your mind, yeah? So in your very own mind, you perform your aarti. Good for now, we join aarti, we chant.
Aarti Shri Ram.
Thank you. Bye.
children, you may have your seat. And then I will hand you over to this wonderful group who will sing for us. And then there's a little special song that was requested. I don't know if you know, I do not have a voice. I've had a virus over the past weekend. Avinash took me on Wednesday, but maybe on Friday I will not be able to talk. Jai Bhagwan, everything seems to be okay. I'll hand you over to Sunil ji. And here, I want to thank you tremendously for coming, for your love, for supporting the family. I want to thank Pandit Randy Ragbir, wonderful energy you have created before. You can reach here, Pandit ji. Thank you so much for setting the pace. To our sound system engineer, Anand Kisoon, to the members of the Temple in the Sea, the Dalvish in the Mandir Ramayana Group, Sunil Ramsundar ji, and others. And of course, from the temple in Dalvish, I have almost half the executive here. Our vice president is here with his wife, and our secretary and assistant secretary, and some children. So to each and every one of you, I thank you tremendously. Now I hand you over to Sunil Ramsundar ji.
सूरज का बडूरी गगन से
चंदा कब दूर किरण से, खुशबू कब दूर पवन से, कब दूर पहाड़ चमन से, ये बंधन तो प्यार का बंधन है, जन्म का संगम है, ये बंधन तो प्यार का बंधन है, जन्म का
Please stand, have dinner with us, yes? Have your RT, have your prasad, and have dinner with us.